this word abstract is a confusing word in art. Now, when you say abstract, it means from some object you take out the skeleton, the shape of it. That's an abstraction from that sculpture or a painting. Its composition, the way it's put together, and you take those out like a geometrical thing, and you see, you know, in painting they show you to get the perspective and how the things are balanced, they draw a square. Now that is abstracting from the painting. Abstracting is to taking away. Tract is to move, and ab is to take away. So it's taking away the abstraction. Now in mathematics, when they talk of abstracting, it's the same thing. It's from an equation, you're taking some part of it and then using it for something else. That's abstraction. In the case of art, it is used like, you know, he was abstracted, that is, he was in a sort of wandering mind. When you say he was abstracted, it means that he was not all there. He was, you know, in a state where he was in a state of abstraction, that you say he that's quite a different sense of the meaning, abstract. Now in painting, I don't know what they talk about when they say abstract. Because if it is abstraction, let us say you take Picasso, he draws bulls for the bullfighting, and you see whole sketches, and the bull he's drawing properly and gradually, and right at the end there's only little line and this thing, and now that's the abstraction from the original. That is what is meant, I think, in art, is that you're taking away all the unnecessary stuff and leaving the core thing behind. And that is interesting to follow, especially when you see people like Henry Moore, and all. If you look at their sketches, from original things, the final thing is a minimal thing of what that shape is. Now in the case of, when you talk, you look at all these paintings of abstraction, there's a lot of shapes going around, right? But you don't know where they are abstracted from. They are merely what the artist likes. I do that myself. Now most of the time, now that I paint, now I start by taking a piece of paper and with, say, any color like red or blue, and I put a patch on the paper. And then I look at this patch and think, now where can I go from here? So it's like you're dressing. You wear this t-shirt and I think, maybe not this watch. And you put a different bracelet, or women wear different scarf. They are taking the original idea and adding to it various things. Now that is exactly what I'm doing in painting. From what is there, the shape and the color, I keep adding things. Quite often it looks boring and I throw it away. Otherwise, when I end up, it looks like a painting. Yeah, what I started, not, I didn't look like a painting. But when you look at it at the end, there's something about the, like you take Jackson Pollock. What is the meaning of Jackson Pollock? There are a lot of figures going around the place. Neither. But when you look at it, the whole thing, and all those figures, like in a forest, all the scrub things are intertwining and they form an interesting, for you and also for him. There are some people who look at Pollock and say, what bloody rubbish. But there are others who look at it and say, my God, they're brilliant. So it is about the person who looks at it, and especially for the guy who does it. I remember when I was very small, we were living in a remote, in Mahadampe, and in the night you could hear owls, like ulama and all sorts of owls screaming their heads out. I was frightened. I was about 4 years old and I was frightened of owls. But then I saw one day the caretaker shot an owl. that was on the ground is beautiful, the feathers and everything. So I started by drawing that owl, and gradually I got into liking owls. When Jeffrey asked me to do a sculpture for that place, right up the stair, right in front of the dining room, and I designed this sculpture, and he looked at it, very nice, lucky, but let's not call it an owl, because all these board directors, owl kiwama, that's a bad idea. People don't like owls here. Like in the West, owl is considered the, you know, the wisdom, symbol of wisdom and all of that. So I said, that's all right, we'll call it the eagle. Who's to know? So I did the sculpture. Now, of course, owls are considered very bad from people's mythology here. So within a week of by putting the sculpture there, Jeffrey used to smoke a lot, had a fit of coughing and fell on the floor and cracked his head, and he was in hospital for 2 days. About a month later, Milroy Pereira was in a conference in the Galadari Hotel or something, and a whole mirrored ceiling crashed, and he almost died, and he lost the eye. He almost died, but he lost an eye. And a short while later, the site electrical engineer, coming back in the night, crashed into a lamppost and almost died himself. So there were three bad things that followed this owl. Nothing happened to me, of course. The rain tree is a piece of music I heard many years ago by a Japanese composer. It was called the rain tree. Rain tree refers to our paramara. After rain stops, for about 2-3 hours, you get drops of water coming from the leaves beneath the tree. So it was called the rain tree because it's raining under the tree. And he made this wonderful piece of music. And so this is my version of that piece of music, the abstraction of that form from the music to sculpture. This is what I call bio-architecture, where now it is built. And now birds are building nests in it, spiders are building cobwebs in it, leaves are falling on it and drop off. It's what I call a biosculpture. I make the idea of it and nature does the rest. The artist, we are in the environment, he ingests the environment. Then he digests it like in your stomach, right? What he has taken, he digests. Then he defecates, and his crap is the end product, that's the painting. And then a critic comes along and says, my God, this is well formed. Oh, it's runny and it's like a diarrhea. And then some very rich guy comes and buys it and puts it on his wall, and that's art. I think this whole art thing is a bogus racket. (Laughter)